بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. I praise Allah for what it is due to Him, تبارك وتعالى. And we are ever grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have given us life after He took it from Prince. And He took it from so many people. The world today is shocked by the death of Prince. And I say this because it's on the news. You will not be able to avoid it. But to me, that is the news. It's how I interact with it that makes me valuable or not valuable. As soon as I heard of the death of this artist, I prayed 2 rak'at to Allah, thanking Allah and saying, Ya Allah, I really, really appreciate that you gave me life when you took it from this rich man, from this famous man, and enabled me to worship you more. And you gave me that opportunity. Ya Allah, I'm ever grateful for that. Who has done this, my brothers? This is how you convert any action to tawheed. To any action that you see into tawheed. Why he died, and now the world wants to see why he died? Because they don't believe that Allah can take a soul without any reason. Everything has had to have a reason. Alhamdulillah, we don't live in that thing. His hour has come. End of it. He's worth 200 million or 600 million. His hour comes. End of it. It's what I learn from that makes me valuable or not valuable. At the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was aware of what was happening around him. Some people today, you find him a big sheikh, but he's not aware of what goes on around him. Hardly ever reads newspaper. Doesn't know what happens in the news. But also on the other extreme, some people waste their religion of following what's on the news. We have to strike a balance in between these two worlds. Tonight, I want to talk to you, my brothers. As we see, Ramadan is getting close. Every year, when Ramadan gets close, we start giving talks and get ready for Ramadan. Yet, Ramadan comes in and goes out so many years. And guess what? We are not changing much. All of us claim that Ramadan is here to change us, to help us become better, right? But year gone and year come back, another year comes in, we're still the same. Not much has been accomplished. I'll ask a question. If any of you has experienced one Ramadan where it changed literally his life, raise your hand. Say, that year I fasted that Ramadan, and from then I'm never the same. If we went and to a whole stadium of Muslims, we ask this question. If one raises his hand, we say, Alhamdulillah. But most of the time, nobody's going to raise their hands. Reason being, again, it's not about blaming. It's just the way we have been brought about this Islam. About the way Islam is today to us is not the Islam that impacted the life of a Sahaba. It's not the same Islam. For example, the Islam of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah and Ibn Kathir and many others, if they came in our time, they'll be like scratching their head. This is really Islam. What goes on? Tonight, my brothers, your perception about understanding what Ramadan is, it will change, bi-idhnillah, forever. Tonight, when you leave this room, Ramadan will never mean the same thing to you. Never. This year, Ramadan is going to be the most beautiful, life-changing experience if you take what I'm going to tell you. My job is share with you. And you take that information, build on, act on, entirely up to you. Ramadan, when it gets close, we start saying it's the month of Al-Quran. And they say lots of good things about Ramadan, and rightly so. But there is always one question which we need to ask ourselves about this month of Ramadan, and as a matter of fact, about anything in Islam. Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah alayhi rahmatullah said something beautiful. And Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah is the student of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. 16 years daily studentship with Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. 16 years. What a lot of people don't know, Imam Ibn Kathir, tafsir of Ibn Kathir. Everybody likes it, right? It's famous. Ibn Kathir was a student of Ibn Taymiyyah. When he wrote his tafsir, he gave it to Ibn Taymiyyah to authorize its publishing at that time. Ibn Taymiyyah gave him the go-ahead. And many other people. Many sisters became scholars of Islam under the leadership of Ibn Taymiyyah. But anyway, the Islam that we have today, my brothers, is really, really, really very platonic. In the sense that we all know what a Ferrari is, right? But all we know about Ferrari are two things. It's an expensive car, it's fancy, and only rich people have it. Beyond that, you know nothing except the name. This is how we are with Islam today. We only know something, and that's the end of it. Otherwise, how come Ramadan comes, a life-changing experience, and goes, and we are still there? Let's start with a question. Why did Allah call this month Ramadan? Why he didn't call him Shawwal? Why it's not Sha'ban? Why did Allah specifically call this month Ramadan? Believe me, a huge majority of maximizing and changing your life depends on how much you understand the word Ramadan. And as you will see, it's not an easy job. I'll carry the phone with me so that you get the good recording and you don't get it. There is something in Arabic called the study, or ilm al-judhur. Ilm al-judhur is the study of the root of the words. I gave an example, for example, with read. R-E-A-D. Read, you mean you open a book and you look at it and you read the map, so it's an act of taking information. If I write the same read here, but at the end of the word I add an E-R, your brain only needs to look at the word read and then he goes E-R. It has to do with the reading. I just need to figure out what the E-R means. Right? And then I gave an example about readership. Again, readership. Your brain looks at the first word and he goes read. So here I have read, the first read. So the brain reads into that it has, the third word has to deal with the word reading. If I go like this, outread, the brain still knows it has to do something with reading. I just need to figure out what I add, outread, inread, onread, atread, and you get the idea. So now my question is, why did Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala chose the name of Ramadan and not any other? He could have called the month, for example, the Quran. Or could have called it any name, right? But why Ramadan? Now, here is why, my brother. Again, in the study of the root of the word, I'm going to take three letters which form the word Ramadan. It's Ra, and it's Mim, and it's Dad. Ra, Mim, Dad. I will write this word also differently, where I start with the second letter, Mim, Ra, Da. And then I will start with the third letter, Da, Ra, Ma, or Da, Mim, Ra. These are the four ways of writing a word which has these three letters, Ra, ميم ضاد. Now here is the big beautiful thing about this Arabic, and here we understand why Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala chose Arabic as the final language for the final message. Because it really is a miraculous language. It really is. We are not just saying it. It really is. And you will see. In Arabic, any word where you see the three letters, Ra, Mim, and Dad, in a word, in any form you are, in any form you see it, either the first letter is Ra, Ma, Da, or Ma, Ra, Da, or Da, Ra, Ma, or Da, Ma, Ra, what it means? It means this. To understand that concept, a man, when we are born, there is always an original state. Original state. My original state, is it to be healthy or sick? Healthy. And the exception is when I am sick. My original state is when I am hungry or satisfied? Satisfied. Well, my original state is when I am cold or hot? Hot. So everything that deals with the original state, that's who you are. Exceptions always happen to knock you off that original state. Look at the word now, Ra, Mim, Da. When someone is sick, we say Marid. Right? Marid meaning the person was taken from a state of health to a new state of exception. You with me, my brothers? Very good. Ramad means extreme heat. Extreme heat. So, when we have regular heat, that's good. It's when it's extreme heat that is the exception. Or extreme cold. Marad is sickness. Daram is when you set something on fire. Adrama fihi an-nar. He set him on fire. Daram is when you set something or someone, hopefully not, on fire. Damar is when you keep something secretive. Keep secret. Someone wants to beat up somebody, يَضْمِرُهُ فِي نَفْسِهِ, meaning he hides it within himself and does the action without the other person knowing. As you can see here, that there is some original meaning around the three letters, right? And what it is to shift someone or something from their original state. You with me, my brothers? Are you looking at that phone because you're doing something, or you're sending a text? Oh, come on, my brother. No Quran, please. Huh? Huh? Put reference later. Follow with me. Okay? Now, so here, when it, now let's see what Ramadan, what is the relationship with Ramadan, with all what I'm saying, so that you understand what Ramadan does to us. Ramadan, all year long, we are living according to a pattern. You wake up in the morning, you eat, you drink, you do certain things, right? Ramadan, the first thing comes is he shakes you, he shifts you from an original state. Ramadan shifts you from an original state. First of all, things that are halal, like eating, drinking, no longer are halal. Isn't that amazing? Are you with me, my brothers? People who smoke, they say, I can't quit smoking. Ramadan comes in 16 hours fast, and they fast for 16 hours, then don't touch smoke. And Ramad, what is it? Marad. Oh yeah, on top here, extreme heat, which leads to what? Extreme thirst. Extreme thirst. Are you with me, my brothers? Because this, you understand, this Ramadan this year will change your life. So here is a month that is coming that is bringing with him a series of things to shift me from where I have been for the past 11 months to take me to a new zone, which is not my zone. Remember, when you are hungry, is the exception. Ramadan takes you from the norm to the exception. Ramadan takes you from the norm to what? Zakallah khair. So we're going to write this one. Ramadan takes me, so it takes me from the norm to the exception. Many people don't stand at night for Salat Taraweeh at Qiyam al-Layl, right? Ramadan comes, they do that. A lot of people don't donate sadaqah on a daily basis. Ramadan comes, he shifts them, they start donating. Isn't that true? And so many things happen. Ramadan triggers a state in us that is not the same state we have been living in the past 11 months. A man is made of two things, my brother. Every human being is made of two things. A physique, a human body, and a spiritual side. When one of them is not functioning, the person is no longer fulfilling his duty on earth. Meaning someone who eats a lot and is not religious, or someone who is too religious and doesn't work this dunya. Islam says it's between the two. Maximize on the khair of the dunya and work for the Yawm Al-Qiyamah. Have you written all this? Can I turn up because you know? Okay. So Ramadan, what it does, it shifts me from the norm to the exception. Yes, I like that. So here is what you are going to do. I'm going to write that one there. Ramadan shifts me from the norm to the exception. Okay? Please keep this with you from now until you die. Every Ramadan, and you will see why it is what we should be doing. A man is made of humans. We are a soul and we are a body. We are a soul and we are a body. The body itself, we are made of two things. We are made of food and we are made of water. Oxygen and things like that, they are extra, but I'm talking here about food and water. But the soul is made of one thing, divine guidance. Divine guidance. Keep in mind now Ramadan about the extreme heat, and also which leads to extreme thirst. This is what Ramadan means, the extreme heat, extreme thirst. With me, Hassan? Mantaz. Now, Allah in Al-Quran and the Hadith many times refers to the guidance and huda min Allah and Al-Quran. He refers, Allah many times in Al-Quran, refers to Al-Quran as water. وَنَزَّلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً مُبَارَكًا. So many ayat, Allah gives the example of a person who is dead without Al-Quran, without the guidance. And when Allah sends Al-Quran on him, the man is revived just like the earth is revived. Many ayat in Al-Quran speak about that. Yeah, the guidance, Islam, the whole. Because look, when I say Al-Quran, I mean Sunnah, Al-Islam as a whole. But because of Islam, the root of the heart of it is Al-Quran. Here, my brothers, you understand that Al-Quran has got what? Water. Look, when Allah talks about the kuffar who do not listen to the da'wah, he goes, كَبَاسَتِ كَفَّيْهِ إِلَى الْمَاءِ, as the one who spreads his palm to the water, لِيَبْلُغَ فِيهِ, so that it reaches his mouth, وَمَا هُوَ بِبَالِغَ, and the water will never get to his mouth. See? So Allah here explains Al-Quran as water, and just the kafir who holds it, meaning the people who don't take the extra step to learn about this religion. They want Allah to, one day they wake up and they say they've got everything covered for them. So Al-Quran here is water. Water gives what? Life. Right? So, water here, oh, let's put it here, water gives life. That's why you cannot eat for 40 days, but you cannot not drink for 40 days. Someone says, you know what, I only drink fizzy drinks, or I don't drink, I don't eat. If you don't drink and you eat food, your body will take as much water from the moisture of the food. It will try to work with whatever you intake. Okay, don't think like you don't drink water, meaning, no. So here, as you can see, our life, when we plant a flower on the floor, in the floor, in the ground, what do we water it with to give it life?
Water.
Water. We give it what, my son? Water. If we want to paint the wall and you bring only powder to give it that fluidity to paint with, we need what?
Water.
And that's why Allah says in the Quran, وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. And we made out of water anything, hey, comes to life. Wood, it's completely dry. Put it in water for an hour, and you find it has life in it. The iron, you put iron in water with time, the iron will change the life of that water. Right? Water is unbelievable, my brothers. So here is experience. Allah named the month of Ramadan because mankind will always be thirsty for the divine guidance. Allah named him Ramadan because mankind will always be thirsty for the divine guidance. Write that one down, my brothers. Allah named Ramadan, Allah named it Ramadan because humans will always be thirsty for divine guidance. This is why, my brother, in Mu'jam al-Tabarani, in a hadith authenticated by Sheikh Nasruddin al-Albani alayhi rahmatullah, every single book revealed by Allah unto any prophet was revealed in Ramadan. Every, this is, this today is an introduction to Ramadan. Next week we'll bring the book.